Do you want to add video or animate your InDesign document? Well, here's one way to do it using Illustrator and After Effects. So imagine that the client sends you an InDesign document and asks you to create a couple of social posts to help promoting the content, in this case, a cover of a music tech magazine. Inside InDesign, you are quite limited when it comes to working with video and audio. You can use the media panel to place simple, small video and audio files, but it doesn't support Alpha Channel, and if you need to animate other objects like lines or text, there's no easy way to pull it off over here. This may change in the future, but until it does, or just in case, you've been asked to start your process from an InDesign file, here is my recommended workflow. So the first thing that I'll do is just make sure that I'm seeing the same colors when I'm designing for video. I'll go to the Edit menu, and under Color Settings, I can switch the working spaces from sRGB to Rec. 709. So I'll choose this one, and then OK. Another thing you can do is go to the File menu, and under Document Setup, you can change your intent from print, which is the default, to web or mobile. So both of these are going to switch you from millimeters, centimeters, or whatever you're using to pixels, which are easier to work with when you are going for video or screen sizes. In fact, inside the mobile options, you have few page sizes that you can choose from this pop-up menu. So this is totally up to you. I'm going to override those sizes anyway in the next step, so I'll cancel out of this. And now I need to export this from InDesign so After Effects can read it. And there's no easy way to do it, so we are actually going to use PDF and go through Illustrator and then prepare our file over there for animation inside After Effects. So I'll go to the File menu and choose Export. You can also press Command E here on the Mac, Control E on the Windows side, and I'll save it on the desktop. Now, my recommended workflow is to choose the first option here, Adobe PDF Interactive. You can also go with print, it doesn't really matter, but because the destination is screen, I'll choose Interactive. Then I'll click Save, and this is very important. If you have more than one page, you'll need to export each one of the pages individually. So don't use all, just use range and select the different pages. And this will make sure that we are respecting the layers that we defined here inside InDesign. Otherwise, Illustrator, which is going to be our bridge, is not going to be able to read it unless you are separating each one of the pages to a single PDF. So in my case, it doesn't really matter. And this is basically it. We don't need to worry about anything else in this dialog. So I'll go ahead and click Export. It's going to warn me that this document is using CMYK blending space and colors are going to be converted to RGB, which is exactly what I want. So I can actually check this one, don't show again, or I can just click OK to continue. And after a few moments, it's going to export the PDF, and in my case, it's also going to open it in my default PDF viewer, which is preview, so I can compare between those two, and I think it looks correct. So I'll quit out of preview, and then I'll switch to Illustrator, and over here, I'll go to File, Open, navigate to the desktop, and select the PDF that I just exported from InDesign. I'll click Open, and it's going to show up as one single layer, but at least it looks identical. So I can see the color mode is RGB, which is great. If for some reason you are still seeing here CMYK, the first thing you should do is go to the File menu and then change the document color mode to RGB. The second thing is to arrange everything over here, basically recreate the layers for animation. So if I'll open up layer number one, and then I'll twirl down the clip group, we can see that all the content survived. So we can actually rearrange it over here, and then separate those layers and path to different layers. So first I'm going to select this clip group, and I'm going to do some housekeeping over here. this clipping object is something that I don't need. I'll select and delete it. And then I'll add layers according to what I want to do inside After Effects. So I'm going to add a new layer and I'll name it bar. I'll grab this clip group and drag and drop it to this layer. So this is the bar layer. And I actually need to change the blending mode since I'm breaking the InDesign order. So I'm going to click over here and switch it to multiply. And this is something which is not going to survive when I'll bring it into After Effects, but at least I can judge the result over here. Okay, the next layer is the one with all the path and the graphic elements. So again, I'll click on the plus icon, double click and name it elements. And I actually want the elements layer to be underneath the bar layer. And then I'll select all the things that I want to be included in this layer. So basically all of these things, and then I'll move all the elements over here. The next layer is going to be the text layer. So I'll name it text. I'll drag it underneath the elements, and then I'll select all the text objects that I have here and then drag and drop them over here. And I want to show you that if I'll click on, let's say, this music layer, this is still live text. So if I want, I can change it over here, or there are a few ways to send this live text to After Effects. One of them is using copy and paste. The other one is, of course, using the overload extension that I've talked about in my Illustrator to After Effects integration video. The link is in the description. Okay, I don't need the page number here, so I'm just going to select and delete it. This clip group that I chose not to take is the outline for the text. And I'm going to delete it and instead select this text and create a stroke from here using the appearance panel. I'll change the color to white. And this is just going to make things a bit more easier when we are bringing it to After Effects. So you need to be mindful for those duplicated elements, usually in the form of clip groups. If you don't need them, just get rid of them or recreate them the same way I showed you. Okay, the next thing is our image. So I'll create a new layer. I'll name this one image, and then I'll take the image. This is just going to be a placeholder and place it over here. And finally, everything that I have here, except of the background, is the logo. So I'll double click on this. I'll change it to logo. I'll take all the logo elements and place them underneath the word logo. And I'm going to select the word logo, create a new layer, bring it under everything and name it background. And then just take this group or even just this path and place it over here. So I know it looks like a lot of work, but this is your best bet when you want to animate those layers inside After Effects. Now, before we're going to move this document to After Effects and animate the layers over here, we also need to set the size. So I'll click on the artboard tool, which is going to show me the current dimensions. And because I want to create an Instagram post, I'll double click on the width value and change this value to 1080 pixels and then tab to the height and change it to 1350 and then press Command or Control 0 to see how this looks. I'll return back to the selection tool. And then I'll make sure to select all the layers here by pressing Command A. And then I'll scale everything by holding down Shift and make sure that it fits the new size. So you may need to do this in few goes. And then I'll deselect everything. Just click on the background layer and make sure to just scale this one so it will fit the new aspect ratio. So now I can just save this document as a PDF file. I'll switch now to After Effects, and then I'll double click in an empty area in the project panel and select the PDF that I just saved from Illustrator and click Open or Import on the Windows side. Now, After Effects can identify multi-layered PDF the same way it works with Adobe Illustrator. Actually, it's the same format. So it offers us the option to create a composition out of it, and we are also going to respect the layer size dimensions. So I'll click OK, and then I'll double click to open this multi-layer PDF file inside After Effects. And you can see that everything is being respected except of the multiply blending mode for this bar. So we can, of course, select this layer and switch it to the multiply blending mode. And this will help us to match the original InDesign design. And just to show you, I'll switch to InDesign and compare between those two. And it looks similar, except of course for the things that we took off, such as the page number, which is irrelevant, and of course the extra margins that we've added inside the Illustrator. But other than that, this document is now ready to be animated. Now, it's always a good practice to go to the composition settings and just verify that everything indeed is what you are expecting it to be. So in this case, the width and the height is okay. The frame rate, I'm going to leave it at 30 frames per second. And the duration is what you want. So in my case, it is 5 seconds. I'm going to click OK. And then let's quickly animate a few of the layers as well as replace the image placeholder with a video file. So I'll start with the bar layer over here. I'll go to Effects and Presets and start to type Linear, which is going to show me the Linear Wipe animation preset. So notice I'm taking something which already has some keyframes, so not the regular transition. I'll double click to apply it, and I'll change the wipe angle to 180 degrees, and then press spacebar to show you what I'm getting. So something very simple, it doesn't need to be complicated. But I want the logo to react to this line, so I'll select the logo over here, I'll clear the search, and I'll type in bounce. I'll close the things that I don't need to see, and I'll double click on this scale bounce layer markers. And this is going to apply this behavior to the logo layer. Now this behavior is sensitive to layer markers. So over here, when the bar completes its animation, I'll select the logo layer and then go to the layer menu, and under markers, I'll add the marker. You can also use Control 8 from your keyboard. And as you can see, this is going to change the scale of this layer. Now I think the target scale is just too big, so I'll change it to 150, as well as enable continuously rasterize for this logo. Remember, this is still a vector layer. So just to show you what we've managed to create, this is it. And finally, I'll select the image placeholder layer, go to the project panel, and over here, I have a video version of this young lady. So I'll hold down the Option key, Alt on Windows, and I'm going to drag and drop this on top of the footage, and this is going to replace this image with a video layer. So if I go to the beginning and preview this, we have something that works really nicely as an Instagram post. Now, because this is After Effects, we can always visit this composition. I'll double click on it. It's going to open in a new tab. And then under the effect, I can actually switch off the black and white effect and compare it with the previous one. So again, depending on what you want to do, maybe you want to take away this bar and just leave yourself with this very colorful version. Let's maximize it so we can see it in its full glory. And this is my workflow when I need to base my animation on an InDesign document. So I hope this will help you with your work. And until next time we'll meet, my name is Eran Stern, and thank you so much for watching.